Hemant Dangi from Oracle MySQL, and he will be talking about the MySQL group replication. So here you go.
Hello everyone, my name is Hemant Dangi and I work for MySQL group replication team, and today's my topic for presentation is the state of art on MySQL group replication. In this topic I would be basically telling you the basics of group replication, and mostly would be focusing on new 8.0 features which we have introduced recently. This safe harbor statement, whatever I am presenting here, don't make your decision on purchase based on my presentation. This is just for information. As I told you, my program agenda, like basics of what we have currently in 5.7 in group replication, I would be telling you that. And the main focus would be on 8.0 features, which we have introduced in 8.0. Okay, what is MySQL group replication? It's a single multiple primary update everywhere replication plugin for MySQL. With this, you can have a automated distributed recovery, you can have a conflict detection and group membership. MySQL group replication, this plugin is what for the development side, we actually divide this plugin into two parts. One is MySQL group replication, the other part we call as a MySQL GCS, group replication communication system. The GCS component is this XCOM. So XCOM is the tool which actually maintains this communication between different members of the group. And this is a Paxos, based on Paxos. And it's, this tool main functionality is order delivery, dynamic membership, and failure detection. If you go in the, this whole group replication plugin, this XCOM communicates with the group. This group replication plugin actually is an interface between this XCOM, GCS, and the rest of MySQL, where we capture incoming data and broadcast it to, we give it to XCOM and XCOM broadcast it to all other members. I will go in detail how exactly group replication work in later on slide. Basically group replication needs a few things. If you are using a group replication, you need to have a primary key, because it has to distinguish two similar keys are added at the same time on different members. So how, if they are same, then there wouldn't be a collision. So for that, it needs a unique primary key. And InnoDB. InnoDB is a must for group replication. Group replication can be configured in different modes. By default, we have a single primary mode. Single primary mode is similar to a master-slave asynchronous replication. So we have a primary. We have we will have a multiple secondaries. Primary is a master, which we use in asynchronous replication, and slaves are secondary, which we call here in group replication. So by default, if you start a GR, the GR is configured in a single primary mode. And with the GR, it's a automatic conflict detection, automatic failure handling. So if any node goes down, if primary goes down, primary is the node where you will be writing the data, and secondary you would be reading the. Secondary are read enable, and primary is write and read both. So if primary goes down, so we have to have a new primary. In asynchronous replication, we do a slave promotion. Here, this is automatic. Whenever primary fails, primary member election starts on every individual node independently of other nodes, and it will choose a new primary, and you would be writing on this primary, and others would be read-only. This primary would be changed to read and write. The other mode we have is a multi-primary mode. This is all members would be primary. You can enable it using group replication single primary mode. This is a system variable to make it off, and it would be enabled. So you can write all members would be read and write in a read and write mode. You can write on any members, but two similar statement has been executed, the first whoever would be reached would be get committed, and the other would get rolled back. So example where A is a primary key here, so two different statement, they won't collide here. So they get executed and both would get committed. If we execute two statement which have A is equal to A1, A is equal to 1 as a primary key, they are similar statement and they can collide. So whoever, they are executed at the same time on different members. So whoever is first would win and the other would get rolled back. This only one would be first because of the order delivery, which I told you happens because of the XCOM and Paxos. And how group replication exactly works here. We have a group of five members. We have clients, three clients. One client is inserting one client is, other client is inserting two here. And it reaches the MySQL server. So before it gets committed, if you are writing a transaction, you write commit colon. So before it actually gets committed in the server, this write sets and GTID executed is broadcasted. Is first write set is generated. Write set is actually a hash value of primary key, foreign key, and table name and other data. So that write set, GTID executed, and data is broadcasted to all the members. And on the receiver node, it is first certified. What does certification means? It is when you are getting the data, it is actually maintaining a certification DB. Certification DB contains this write set, and it would be verifying that, this primary key is not there from other member also. And GTID executed makes sure that statement is executed is the there is no gap between this statement and other statement. So they are in continuous. So this would make sure this would on the receiver side, if it's certified, and if certification is successful, then it gets committed. If certification is unsuccessful, then the one that would be rolled back. And this happened individually on every node. There is no communication. Here, when this certification is happening, there won't be an acknowledgement to other member that, this is rolled, has to be rolled back. To make it fast, they work independently. They just maintain the state with the GTID executed. So every member is having the same GTID executed. So they are in the same state. And you don't acknowledge every statement from the other member. So to make it fast. Now what we have in 5.7, already we have in group replication features which we have in 5.7. I will tell you in brief about that. Automated distributed server recovery. Whenever new member joins, all the data that new member doesn't have, it's replicated and it's brought to the same state to which other members are in. So that happens automatically. You don't have to set up any kind of replication, asynchronous replication. You don't have to transfer any data here. That happens automatically, and that is handled by group replication. full GTID support, like from the start, it's based on GTID only. Without GTID, like to make keep the state, we use GTID. So it's and it's completely it completely supports GTID. Auto increment configuration handling. Like if you want, like if you're inserting data and you don't want to see that many collisions and you want auto increment key, so you can set up auto increment key where, like suppose if you have three members, then you can put a you can put server ID as the start of the auto increment key and offset as is default as 7. It can be changed with this group replication auto increment. So if you have three servers, so server ID, you have first server, you have given server ID 1, second 2, and third server ID 3. So the inserts would be like this: 1 on the first server, 1, 8, 15 on the second server, 2nd, 16 plus 7 on the third server, 3, 9, and plus 7. Like these, so there won't be any collision between these inserts. Plugin version access control, like we are maintaining on this group replication, we are maintaining that there is like when a group has a lower member version, like 5.7, and a new member joins with the 8.0. So if this new member joins with the 8.0, it doesn't have, like it would be set up, it would be set up in a read-only mode. So that like new changes which we have brought in 8.0, like which are not compatible with the older version, doesn't affect the working of group. And when we have a 8.0 group, then a 5.7 member is not allowed to join because it like the new older nodes, newer nodes would be writable, and those changes can't be, won't be compatible with the older version. So this is inbuilt in group replication. We have a read-only mode. Whenever a member leaves a group, read-only mode is automatically enabled. So that when a new data, by mistake of a user is writing new data on that node, and if it tries to rejoin later on, that data would mismatch with the rest of the group. We keep a state with the GTID executed, so this would create issues. So we keep the member which we make the member which leaves as a read-only mode. So this kind of mistake doesn't happen. Full stack secure connection. In read-only mode, we actually put all the secondary members in the single primary mode. We make them also as a read-only. Like user doesn't have to do. They are enabled as a read-only by group replication plugin only. Full stack secure connection, like this is group replication, like supports secure connection along the complete stack. Like it is in the, like group replication from the start has this enabled this secure connection. And you can, like in the cloud, it can have an issue that, okay, if like a host tries to join a group which you doesn't want, so you can whitelist IPs that only are allowed to join the group to make it secure. Parallel applier support. If you have seen that Venkatesh presentation, right set based, which makes this applier faster, and it's a parallel in a parallel can be applied, so that right set based applier is there in MySQL group replication from the start. From the 5.7, it is always there. In replication, they would be enabling it soon. Now, like in 8.0, we have enabled. Now, in 8.0, we have enabled lot of we have put lot of new features based on community request, and most of the features were lot of features were added to make the group replication stable and secure. One of the feature was primary election weight, where before this. Who will be selected as a primary was based on the UUID. In 8.0, we added this weightage. So you can put weight on different members. If you have a stronger server, you can assign it a higher weight. That would be selected as a primary. And if that goes away, the member with lesser weight than that would be selected as a primary, would get selected as a new primary, and so on. How it actually works, if you look at the MySQL queries, like there are three members in the group. One is a primary. If you like I am setting for this member A, group replication member weight is equal to 0, and assigning this member C as 100. For B, its value is 90. We shut down this server MySQL A, we shut down. Then we run this query. We would see guest chosen as primary now. All the information about the group, member weight, versions, if it's online, offline, it's always present, I mean, like it's always there on all other members. Like you don't have to go and check individual member that, okay, whether it's online or not. You can query any of the performance, I mean, like you can query performance schema, this replication group members, and you will know status of other members also. Caring about data. What I told you, like in 8.0, we added lot of features which related to making the members stable and secure. So, like this, a member A is joining here. It's in a single primary mode. A joins. A becomes a secondary. It's automatically enabled as a read-only member. If it leaves, or it's kept as a read-only member, so that it can join and it doesn't have unnecessary data. If you look at the MySQL queries, A is a, and this member is a primary. You check super read-only mode. Super read-only mode is 0 here. You stop group replication, the member becomes offline. But still, super read-only mode becomes 1 here. It leaves, super read-only mode is enabled. Asynchronous replication, member leaves the group, asynchronous replication is also stopped. If on secondary, asynchronous replication are not allowed because they are read-only. And if there is already asynchronous replication, they are it's not allowed to become a secondary of the group. We have this automatic flow control, where if one of the node is not able to cope up with the other members, then this throttling mechanism, flow control mechanism kicks in. It will slow down the other servers. Here in this case, B is not able to cope up, A and C throttling is enabled, and when B becomes stable and is able to, I mean, like it's in the same state when like others, so this throttling stops and everything works normal. Network partition, I mean, like this was like one of the community requests, where like if network partitioning happen, network partition, what happened, like okay, A and B are not able to communicate with the C and D, and if they are in the same network and they are not able to communicate, A and B not communicate with C and D, but A and B both can communicate with each other, they can see each other, C and D both can communicate with each other. So you can we added one this group replication enable unreachable majority timeout. You set its value, like you set its value as a 1 minute, 60 seconds. Then after 60 seconds, the members which are in minority will stop automatically. Here, there are four members. So minority, both are in minority. These two, both groups are in minority. So whole group goes dissolve. We also added a group replication force members. If this partition happen and you can give IP address of particular members, they will stay and others will get shut down. If you want, okay, like there are two partition and you want one of the partition to get dissolved, so you can do it manually with the force member. This is the end goal of what we are looking in the MySQL group replication, what we want in MySQL group replication. Basically, we also have an InnoDB, scripting API. So, to set up MySQL group replication more easily, that you can do with the InnoDB cluster. And you can, you can set up multiple replicas across WAN. This is our end goal, and with the multiple single primary clusters, and it can be with the router, writes can be sent to masters and reads can be directed to secondaries. This way we want everything, this whole system, to evolve. Right now, you can get MySQL group replication GA in 5.7.21 and 8.04 RC, we have. But very soon, 8.05 GA is also coming, which will be having these all features. But you want to test, you can go for 8.04 RC also. Lot of this blogs about all these features. We have added in the MySQL high availability. High availability, you will get all the blocks about replication, group replication, all the replication related features you will get blocks about in MySQL high availability. Documentation you can get in the devmysql.com and you can download from the MySQL website. Thank you. Questions?
So when you were saying when you add a new node, you do the IP whitelisting, right? Does that need a restart?
IP whitelisting should be there before when in this new member is coming.
Yeah.
So in the rest of the members.
Yes.
So they allow it to join the group.
Yeah. So this is a new server, right? So it will be a new IP.
Hmm.
So you are doing IP whitelisting.
IP whitelisting. Okay. I'm not sure. I have to check whether it restart. But most probably. IP whitelisting won't require a restart. I'm not sure of the whether it's a dynamic or a static. If it's a dynamic, then it won't require a restart. I have to just check.
The data, it gets pulled automatically.
Yeah, data, it gets pulled automatically.
So, can we configure where it needs to pull it from? Or it will
That will be selected by MySQL group replication automatically. You just have to provide group replication group name and what all rest of the parameters, configuration parameters you have. Nothing else. It would decide from where it sets up a asynchronous replication between this new member and one of the member which is chooses to send the data, and that all is automatically. You will never see. If you enable group replication, you will see two asynchronous replication channels being made inside the server. One is recovery. This recovery actually is used for, recovery channel is used for this data transfer. And applier is used for when you get data from the rest of that broadcast which I showed you, that is applied using this applier channel.
Can you please explain how throttling is done?
Throttling actually, Venkatesh, you know better than on throttling. Flow control.
For example, the case wherein you have three nodes in the group, one node is not able to catch up.
Okay.
You said there is some throttling.
Yeah, you.
Okay, so your question is how does it internally work?
Yeah.
How does it, when you say throttling is done until one node is not
correct.
Able to catch
up? Correct. So we have queues at every node. Where these are the queues that you can imagine it as a relay log queues. So we know every node will be communicating the size of the queue that it has to be applied. For example, on a node 2, you have something like a 100 transactions that are ready to apply. So it will give you the information saying that, okay, my queue is getting full. that means I'm not able to cope with you guys. Can you please reduce? So what on the server that is pretty fast, what they do is they introduce a slight delay in their commit. So the transaction
comes
back, right? Yes,
we have it
because there are five groups, and this is a group replication. So you want all those five nodes to be in sync.
No, you can.
Correct. There is a performance. Correct. There is a performance here. So that's the reason you can identify whether there is a one particular node that is going back and then it is making the system to slow. You will be able to make out using the performance schema. Then you can actually see that okay, so fourth node is actually the main purpose of the reason. So then you can kick him out. And then the rest of the four guys will.
Venkatesh, let me interrupt. See, this can be enabled and disabled. It's based on the user. Nobody is forcing you to enable it, okay? And there are lot of group replication flow control variables through which you can configure how exactly you want, what the size, lot of things are there through which you can configure. If you're writing on one of the node and reading from others, you want all in the same state. There is no data difference here. So flow control would help in that.
Okay, so I have a facility where I can say if one node is not able to catch up, remove from the group,
yes,
until it catches up.
Yes. You don't have to actually remove. I mean, it's going to be a pretty temporary situation. So the node C's buffer is full and it's just allowing just telling to other people saying that, okay, you guys are pretty fast, I have some problems, so let me just execute my buffer and then wait till them. It's not going to be a major delay, it's just a very minor delay to reduce the performance of other nodes so that these guys. And you don't want that to happen, you can investigate. It could be because of the CPU or it could be because of some hardware issues. You can kick him out, do the repair and then put him back in. But as long as they're in the group, you have to make sure that all the five people are perfectly running at the same time.
Sync.
Otherwise, there will be a lot of other issues that the particular node is having. Stale data and the lag is too much. That node, even though that node is in the group, there is no use.
If you really have no problem with this lag, then you can use asynchronous replication also. Group replication is a virtually synchronous replication plugin. So it has to make sure that everything is in same state.
Oh, okay.
So flow control would help you. Okay. Or otherwise use very, very good servers. Okay. You will never have a problem.
Okay.
Any of your customers using this feature?
Group replication?
Yeah.
Yes.
Yeah, Ricky can tell you better.
allow me to answer that.
Give you 2 minutes.
Group replications, right now we have a number of customers expressing interest, especially because it is easier for them. Previously they have been using InnoDB, and then now the cluster is actually running.
No, my question is, there are lots of persons expressing interest.
But is that in production?
Is it in production?
It is. Okay, for example, since you guys are in Singapore, I'm not supposed to say the name, but I will just say that one of the most prominent payment processors that we always use everywhere you pay, that guy is using group replications in almost every single project, and in the future also every single application.
You really want to know the name? You really want to know the name? You can read blogs of famous people from these companies, few companies. You will find, I can tell the name, but yeah, there are two big companies which are using group replication. You can read blog from them, and they are the most feedback provider for this group replication.
Okay.
I can tell you the name.
One more thing is Tesla is actually evaluating us. Tesla.
Okay.
They are evaluating them. to consider
group replication, the tables and it is not shared, right? It is just for high availability.
Yes, yeah. It's not for sharing, it is high availability.
So is there any plan in future we are going for sharing?
He explained in the end group.
Yeah,
we are going towards there. Whatever you are.
So MySQL router was sitting outside will if when it actually can this will have the sharding feature, then it can shard between different groups.
We have to make the router data aware.
Yeah.
So it will have a transaction manager also, like not only resource manager, it will have a transaction manager.
Why is it need a transaction?
When it is sharded, when
it should be data aware. Transaction doesn't have to maintain by
the application needs to be aware of the sharding.
If you are going through the router, application doesn't have to worry. Right?
Oh yeah, that's right. So that means you got to incorporate the two.
All components. The things that you are thinking will be incorporated in.
Yeah.
I will throw it in a second because he earned it. He asked the question.
You
asked three questions. I was so sad that you left.
You should usually introduce the gauntlet.
No, thank you so much. Yeah. So